am the Marshmallow Queen. I take that title with complete acceptance. I have taken it over from Brent, who was the Marshmallow King. I am now the Marshmallow Queen. And there you go. What a lovely view of some ostriches to start off our morning. It wasn't the animal I was planning on starting the morning off with, but you know, at this point, I think Manu and I will take what we can get. And if it's ostrich and topi, it is ostrich and topi for the opening of our morning. My name is Jamie. This morning, Manu is on camera with me. And we're really muddy. We're really, really muddy. So I would like to tell you a short story. A short story. I'm going to go over the shoulder because this... Please don't splatter me with mud, Mr. Cruiser. Okay, I'd like to tell you a short story. It's entitled Hubris and Regret. And it involves a large puddle that wasn't a puddle. It really wasn't. It was not a puddle. We should have gone through it at high speed. We didn't go through it at high speed. And then we didn't go through it at all. And the worst part is the fact that it happened at about 8 o'clock, Manu, give or take. Are we going to get sprayed in the face by mud? Are we? Just hold on. I'll continue the thrilling tale in a moment. Whee! Morning! You look like you know something I don't. Which at this point is not hard to believe. So the worst part is we actually had to pay somebody to come and pull us out. The even worst part of that was that... He didn't have to pull us out. I was ejected from the driver's seat by quite an excitable man in a red shuka. And he casually drove us out. Look, drove is a strong word. I'm not quite sure how Mila did it. Neither is she. She was smoking by the end of it, but she was out. So there you go. The thrilling tale of the time that Manu and myself got stuck for 2 hours-ish, probably more. The nice thing, of course, about that was that we were out looking for lions and then the lions found us. The not so nice part about that was that they didn't actually come to the vehicle. He just sat and roared where we couldn't see him, so we all had to get back into the vehicle. You actually haven't seen, I've got to show you, you haven't seen my full nighttime attire, but I think you need to admire it now in all its glory. Let me remove my earpiece. Final control will be cursing my name. So, I can't show you what Mila looks like. I can sort of show you what I look like. My microphone is going for a walk. Hold on. So this is, these were kindly donated to me by Graham because, cold. They're now muddy all the way up. And my shoes at one point weighed probably about a tenth of my body weight, possibly more. Now they're looking better. There was about a layer of mud this thick and sort of circular, an elephant-sized footprint. And then I cut my finger on the windscreen, and then we ran out of hot water, and then I found lions that were on the wrong side of the drainage line. Then I couldn't find them this morning. I give up. We tried everything. And there was something else. There was another part of that story I was meant to tell you. What was it? Oh, Anna, we've got the mattresses, but luckily Manu's quite resourceful. He managed to find us some. And that is the tale of our night, pretty much. We have slid and skidded and slid some more, and I have well and truly earned the title of the Marshmallow Queen, which I imagine is going to be lorded over me until he gets stuck the next time. Speaking of him, let's go back to Brent and the Ankhamas.